Hi, this is Karen Dickrell with Glimmers of Joy for April. And our topic for today is, how do you find your happy? So is your happy the bright, colorful pictures that you might see, drawings that you have? Is it music? Is it the people that you talk to and visit? Is it the work that you do? Is it the things that you do for your family? What makes you happy? And then the next question is, where can you find your happy? Well, some people might go for a walk outdoors, some volunteer for a good cause, maybe they're helping at the polls or helping out with some family things that need to get done. Maybe it's a favorite food that you like to make and enjoy the preparation as well as savoring the flavors, or maybe it's singing a song. There's many different routes to happiness, but we hope that when you seek it, that you feel good, that you engage fully, and do the good things that truly do make you happy. So you're not making someone else happy, you're making yourself happy. How can you do that? Well, savor the experiences in your life and really enjoy what you're doing. And to think about what are your favorite experiences and do some reflection time so that you can make sure that those favorite experiences are happening more often in your life. And part of that is to be engaged fully. So pursue your goals and your activities where you're totally engaged, you're immersed in this experience, and you're really enjoying yourself. Part of this might come from just doing things that you do and do it well. And it could be maybe in the month of April that you look at some of the traditions that you enjoy. What do you like to do in the springtime? Are there some spiritual things that happen that are important to you? Are there seasonal foods that you eat? That first asparagus that's just popping up through the ground. What are those things that you experience that make you happy? So as I started out earlier, Our answers may vary. Some people like to take a walk outdoors and take in the budding trees and see the tulips and the daffodils that are popping through. Some people enjoy to volunteer for a good cause or working at the polls or doing things at your church. So finding what's appropriate, what you feel comfortable with, but that you're really happy to do it. Sometimes it's a favorite food. Making that bunny cake where you take the round cake pan and then you do two cake pans. One is round and then the other, you cut out the ears and then you have a bow tie. You know, those kinds of things are fun for yourself, brings back memories, but also to share with your children and grandchildren. Or perhaps it's just singing a song. One of the things I've done in this last couple months is I've gotten a kazoo, and I've been using it at a couple different programs, and I thought I'd just share it with you today. And if you want to sing along to the words, "You are my sunshine that often brightens the day and brings happiness," we'll do that. So don't take my sunshine away. Don't take my happiness away. Find that time to be happy and to celebrate all there is in life. This has been Karen Dickrell, Professor of Family Development with the Human Development and Relationships Institute. I'm a lifespan educator. You can contact me at karen.dickrell@wisc.edu or call 920-832-5126. Have a great time finding your happiness during the month of April. Bye.